It's so this is used to be classmate.
Yeah.
How many years ago? 35? Okay. So this is choose the academic. I am the contractor. I will be more practical in my presentation. We, the contractors, consider time money. It's money, so we have to be efficient somewhat. Okay, my speech, my topic is, I will speak about the possible energy savings from choosing your filtration system in your air conditioning equipment. All the air conditioning equipment, one way or another, they have a kind of filtration. A flat one, a back one, flat back, more complicated ones. We have in the hospitals HEPA filters, afterflow. And all these filters, most of us, they don't see what energy they are consuming to filter the air. So, in my presentation, I will compare the two, and at the end, we have a techno-economic study to see the possible savings of the electrostatic. So, in any air filtering process, we have to, in order to choose the filtration system, we have to consider a lot of factors like the type of pollutants, the shape, the size, the specific weight of the particles, if they are electrically charged or not, their speed. So, and these filters are classified according to how well they are filtering, how well they are separating the pollutants, the particles from the air. So, a mechanical filter usually is made of, most of the time, they're made of nylon or synthetic fibers. They are in Europe. They have classification classes according to their particle collection efficiency: G, E, F, HEPA, and ULPA. The last is the most complicated and most efficient filtration. The first is the basic one. We call it also the G-type, we call it pre-filter. The filtration efficiency of the kind of filters is proportional to the pressure drop. So when they are new, their filtration efficiency is not the best. As it becomes dirty, the efficiency increases. Of course, these filters, after some time in place, they become a source of cross-contamination. They might spread the microbiological load they have collected. It's possible to go back in the airflow. Of course, the mechanical filters have much lower cost than the electrostatic. On the other hand, the electrostatic filter usually is made of aluminium. There is a possibility to treat a number of pollutants and a number of size of contaminants. They also classify according to Italian standard. I'm not aware there is another standard classifying the electrostatic filters into A, B, C, and D. They have a very high level of filtration efficiency, even when they are new. I mean, the filtration efficiency doesn't affect due to the how long is in place or how dirty is becoming the collector. They have very low energy consumption. And with the research studies, they demonstrate that they have a bactericidal action, and they have very low cost of maintenance, and their life is almost forever. Of course, they are more expensive. That's why we don't see so many electrostatic filtration systems. Okay, let's define what is electrostatic. Electrostatic filter is a filter that permits to the device, an air handler or a fan coil, to remove from the airflow the pollutants. The pollutants can be either solid or liquid. Whereas in the case of mechanical, we cannot have liquid pollutants because it will destroy the media of filtration. The system takes two electrical, it works between differential tension, voltage tension, between the emission electrode and the collector sensor. And it separates the particles from the air, which flow through the electrodes. In that way, we remove the contaminants from the air. An electrostatic filtration system has basically consists of three sections. The polarization active section, which makes of filiform emission electrodes, the electrodes that they have the electrical, they are connected to electrical power. The collective passive section made of aluminum plates that they are not connected to the electrical power, but that's why they're called passive, you can remove them. And of course the power supply that generates the high voltage that we need to make the charging of electrodes. The electrostatic filtration started from the industry. Of course, there was an industrial need to make this separation of pollutants, and they found out that using the electrodes was an efficient method. And for years, it was considered very expensive to employ in the HVAC industry. But this is not anymore the case. I mean, we can see commercially electrostatic filtration even in fan coils, smaller devices, whereas the air hand is the main application field. Field that also has the main benefit from the utilization of the electrostatic filtration. We have a picture here. This makes. And you see, usually when we have a filtration system, we have a filter that can be we don't need very high efficiency. We just to cut the coarse, maybe papers in the airflow and other coarse materials. So we have the electrode here that is connected to the electrical supply, and then we have the frame, of course, the yellow one is the frame, and the collectors that they receive the pollutants, the powders, and these collectors are removable for maintenance. Okay, what are the benefits of the electrolyte filtration? We can achieve very high efficiency, higher than 97%, even with a new filter. They have the capability to remove even nanoparticles from the air. They have negligible pressure drop compared to the corresponding mechanical filters, only maximum 30 pascals. And this leads to enormous energy savers. Saving that we see later on. They can remove also bacteria from the air very effectively to kill the bacteria, not to. So they are not anymore source of cross contamination. And they have, through the years, through the time, they have stable performance. Their performance is not affected by being dirty from any other factor like the mechanical filters. Nowadays they can be applied to any HVCT air conditioning device. Of course, there is compliance to the Italian standard UNI 11254/2007, and I will try to prove you that it's a sustainable solution. Okay, this is the round line of the Italian standard that they have classified the electrostatic filters to several classes. We are interested to see that the NDP is the one suitable for air terminals, vacuum, etc. And the AAP is the one that is indicated for air handling application. DP? DP? We lost the track. AP. Yes. BP is what? So there is the efficiency is beyond 95%. And for the fan coils is higher than 80%. So this standard, okay, it's specify exactly the testing procedures, and they have used to reach these results. They make tests in the University of Italy, and they are compared to the mechanical filters. So there is a study done by University of Arbona that they have proven video that the electrostatic filters they can remove the bacterial load from there, and they have followed a specific methodology that so they to calculate the colony. The load, the bacterial load, this is 10 year terms, I'm not aware even most of them, but okay. This is a study behind it. They are not worse. I mean, they have proven that they can remove bacteria from there. And these bacteria are, they are killed on the spot, and they are not able to cross contamination of the air if you suddenly remove, for example, accidentally the plate while the air handling is working. Whereas in the mechanical filters, if someone tried to play with the filters during air handling operation, all the load on the filters can reach, go into the space that people live. So this is indoor air quality compliant from this point of respect. Okay, the electrostatic filtration can be either applied in the field of air handlers to substitute or for new or retrofit applications. And it's indicated, sorry, around here. And usually we replace the bug filters. I mean, we replace the bug filters F7 up to F9 with an electrostatic filter. And the purpose is to gain better filtration results with lower power consumption, to remove from the system the huge pressure drop imposed on the system by the bug filter, which is the numbers are quite considerable, and we see later on. Okay, these modules Usually on a retrofit application, we are able to replace the on the already existing modules on the air handler, which we are taking the F7 back filter, for example, that come in two sizes, 60 by 60 or 30 by 60. There is the manufacturers of the electrostatic filter, they can provide retrofit sizes, so we don't disturb a lot the air handler when you install these electrostatic filters into the unit. Similarly, there is an application for terminal, but there possibly is more difficult. You have to order the functions if you want electrostatic filters from the beginning, as because there are so many manufacturers, so many sizes of factories, it will be quite difficult to get a reasonable price for retrofitting on an existing factory, but there is the possibility there. Okay, to calculate the energy consumed by this familiar formula, which is the, we multiply the energy consumption by the average pressure drop and the time of operation, and we divide by the efficiency of the fan and 1000. Okay, we can see here that the mechanical filter on the table, we can see that the mechanical filter, F9 for example, has a pressure drop initially when clean higher than 90 pascals, and its final pressure drop before replacements can reach 450 pascals. This means that your air handler is working on average with 300 pascal resistor to flow, and it consumes an annual kilowatt hours, 1,250 kilowatt hours. Whereas the corresponding electrostatic filter, initially clean, is only 8 to 13 pascal pressure drop and can reach maximum 30 pascal, which means an average pressure drop only 20 pascals compared to 300 pascals of the mechanical one. And the consumption, the final consumption due to this resistance is only 254, which means we have 1,000 kilowatt hours to save. Today, the European directives, they recognize that if you install a higher efficiency filtration system in your air handler, which removes all these fungus and the bacteria, you can reduce the flows, the fresh air flows that you have on the top, an extra saving from not inducing fresh air, more fresh air than is necessary into the system. Okay, this table is a comparison between the mechanical filter and electrostatic. Okay, what is worthwhile here is that F7, F8, and F9 mechanical filters, usually they are offering in the size 600 by 600, and they are 300 millimeter deep. Whereas the electrostatic filter can be offering the same frame, but it's shorted. We don't need the 300 meters to succeed in efficiency, we need only 10 centimeters. 300 millimeters, we need only 10 centimeters. Okay, there's the efficiencies. I will repeat them, we told them already. Now, the Euroman has classified the filters to categories according to how much energy they are consuming. The formula is in the Euro directory, anyone can find how they reach these results. And an A-plus filter is the one that for F7 can have an energy footprint less than 800. whereas as you, this increases the consumption due to the pressure drop, which increases, it becomes A, B, etc., etc. In our in the counter case of electrostatic filters, there is no characteristic. They don't consider electrostatic filters at all in their classification. They don't classify electrostatic filters. They classify only mechanical filters. But if they had to classify them, I don't know what letter would find, because they consume only 254 kilowatt-hours. So, in the case of mechanical filters, the filters themselves, they are classified dangerous, and they have to be a specific wave management. Of course, in our country, we don't give much attention to that, but in Europe, they have to treat the replacement filters like medical waste. You cannot throw them in the garbage, you cannot burn them on spot. You have to deliver to the authorized company that can manage the waste. Whereas in the case of electrostatic filters, you need a simple wash. The bacteria are already dead, they are not alive, so you just wash it on the spot and put it back. Okay, as a conclusion, I would say the utilization of electrostatic filters is the benefit of air quality and will improve dramatically the quality of air in the inhabited spaces. And so this will the more usage of electrostatic filter will bring multiple benefits to the not only to the owners of the premises but also to the people that live in the buildings. Okay. The energy becomes more expensive, so I think we have to, as engineers, to see the potentials of the electrostatic filters in more frequent, by specifying more frequently air handlers with electrostatic filters. And the reason is not because we are making a favor to the investor, because we'll save money, may pay something higher at the beginning, but we'll save for many years out of the electrostatic filters. So it's, I consider the electrostatic filters a very sustainable green solution. Okay, to prove what I have said, I tried to prepare an economic study using a mall built in here in Cyprus that I have the data, the installation data. Okay, we make this economic study just to prove that it's not only works with numbers, we can prove that these electrostatic filters can pay by themselves their cost and save money and save energy and emissions to save the earth. So go, the result for savings is the small pressure drop compared to the mechanical filter. So we remove 300 pascals and we put back 30. So if we have an inverter on the system, that in buffers more they have, the fan will lower its speeds to meet the same objective, I mean the same flows. So we'll save a lot of, we know that the energy consumption is proportional to the third power of rotation, if I remember where my so here is a table that I signed the cost of using mechanical filters. And you can see if we use the formula, we can reach an annual energy consumption of 19,000 euros using 0.14 euros per kilowatt hour. If we do the same exercise for the electrostatic filter, and assuming that in the previous table also it was included the cost of replacing the filters twice a year. If we do the same table for the electrostatic filters, the annual consumption is only 3,000 euros per year. So this is the photograph, is the construction and how it looks like the electrostatic filter. You see how easy it is to remove the plates and to be clean. And even when it's damaged, you don't lose the whole filtration system. You lose only a small section of the filter. So here is the cost of investment cost for the replacement electrostatic filters. It's quite high. That's why most specified, they don't specify. But we see at the end that it's the benefit of the owner to consider this filtration. So at the end we have the 37 almost thousand investment on, if we add up the installation cost that you need on site to retrofit these filters to existing air handlers, the total retrofit cost is almost 41,000 euros. And we save 23,000. So in less than 2 years, our investment will pay off by itself. The remaining 10 years, 20 years, I don't know what will be the life of the equipment, the investor will put money in his pocket. Okay, thank you for your attention. Any questions? Yes?
About the ozone production during filtration with the
there is here, okay, here in this specific type of electrochemical filters, we have only power on the electrodes. And the fill on the plates is generated by induction. So there is not much ozone production because there no, doesn't, how you say, doesn't charge the air itself.